Anchors up. Sails it full. Welcome to the SlooPcast. How are you doing today, Kyle?
Doing pretty well, Jared. How are you doing today?
Try to put a little stink on that intro, and I think I may have hurt my throat.
All right, I'll do the talking here, Jared. It is our Sloop Picks episode, week two. You know, we all loved the week one picks here, but is week two going to be any better? Probably not, but we're going to go through them anyways. So we have seven games we are going to go through. Well, technically six. Our seventh one, or our first one, depending on which way you look at it, we covered in our last episode. So be sure to check out the Know Your Enemy for Arkansas State to hear what we have to say for that. But Jared, let's get into the picks right off the top here.
I will note that you still have not separated out that text into paragraphs.
I will, but we are going to start.
You said I wasn't allowed to talk.
All right. Well, you're allowed to talk here because we are going to talk about Alabama. Hold on, Jared. This must be a typo. This must be a typo. Alabama going to Texas.
In Dallas? AT&T? Jerry World?
No, it's not in Jerry's World.
What?
No,
I'm good at acting.
Not in Athens, Georgia. This is
Louisiana.
I'm sorry. Atlanta. This is not Atlanta, Georgia. This is
definitely not, wouldn't be Athens.
Yeah. This is not New Orleans.
Not the Superdome? Not Dallas? No.
This is actually in Texas. Austin, Texas.
Are they playing a neutral site at the whatever isn't the Crew team in Austin, Texas? Because surely they're not playing on a campus that isn't their campus. Because that's... When was the last time Bama... I think they played at Penn State a while ago? When was the last time that Bama played out of conference a true road game? Gangland says Penn State 2011.
Has it been that long?
Yeah. Or 12, he says. He says 11 or 12. It's been a minute. Now, give Bama credit. They play a tough opponent every single year, it seems like.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
But that being said, it's always a neutral game in the South. A neutral site game in the South. Now, none of the neutral site games are typically played in the North, except for an occasional Wrigley Field. But even that's typically two Big Ten teams. An occasional Lambeau Field.
But, and by the way, I don't think at Penn State, I don't think that's correct from what I'm seeing here. Unless I'm looking at something wrong. It says here, last time, and I'm going to pull up who it was real quick here. According to what I'm seeing here, last time that they played a true out-of-conference road game, it was in 2004.
You're saying they didn't play at Penn State? And I thought they did.
I will look real quick here. Because that's actually...
While you do that, let me move the show forward. Alabama is, in fact, playing in Austin, Texas, in Memorial Stadium. Shocker. That being said, they're still favored by 20. I think this is the game where a lot of people will be watching. Quinn Ewers had a good game. Considering the opponent, I will say it wasn't a great game. Quinn Ewers in his first ever start, 16 of 24, very good. 225 yards, not bad. Two touchdowns, there you go. Did throw an interception. Louisiana Monroe. It should be noted it was Louisiana Monroe, but it should be noted it was his first ever start in college football. It's going to be a lot different this week. It's going to be a lot different this week.
I did look at a different post, and nope, they were right. It was at Penn State in 2011 was the last time.
Yeah.
For an out of conference.
I specifically remember. And by the way, that was and it's not Alabama's fault. The game was scheduled way ahead of time. I'm not. But this was like crippled post Jerry Sandusky Penn State. Like that was a shell of a team. That was not even proper Penn State. All right. But Austin, in Austin, Texas, Alabama's favored by 20. I was about to say, we're going to find out if Texas is back, but they're not back. If the standard is Bama.
I saw this here and I thought it was pretty funny. Could you imagine the insanity that would be Texas losing to Kansas and beating Alabama within the same 365 day period?
Yeah.
But it's not going to happen.
No,
it's not going to happen. So, but the question is, Jared, will Texas cover the 20 and a half point over under?
Kyle, I'm going to ask you, I'm going to answer that question with a question. Mm-hmm. Did you watch the Georgia Oregon game last week? Did you watch enough of it? No one watched all of it.
Enough.
Yeah, it's gonna be something like that. It's gonna be something like that. Now that being said, I'm not saying I'm all in on Ewers, but he's gonna be better than Bo Nix. So we have that going.
I think the real question is did Ewers get his truck back?
No, it was contractually not the deal.
No, no. Did he get his
truck from the
towing company?
I'm sure. Probably with a handwritten apology note too.
But I agree. I think Alabama's going to cover this. They'll cover the 20 and a half points here.
Yeah, I feel pretty good saying that.
All right. We have here Odin is our guest picker, and he has here Bama will be great this year, but the game will start off slow and a garbage time TD will be scored. So I'm going to guess he's picking Alabama.
Let me check my, maybe there's, Bama and Texas, I believe Bama will win by only 17. I'm sorry. There was two paragraphs here. I didn't get the second paragraph. He is picking Texas.
All right. Next game here on our list, Jared, we have Tennessee and Pittsburgh.
Sounds like a classic AFC Central matchup.
It does, doesn't it? I'm just going to look. Mm-hmm.
Gangland, are you old enough to remember when there was an AFC Central?
Just confirming. And yes, this is in Pittsburgh. Just want to make sure it wasn't like another one of these SEC neutral site deals. We have here Tennessee is a 6.5 point favorite. Now, I didn't watch any of the Tennessee game. I just know that they beat up a MAC school.
Yeah.
But I do know that Pittsburgh did play a Power 5 opponent last weekend.
If we still count the Big 12.
I said Power 5, not Power 3.
even then.
So 6.5, I think, is too much for me. So I'll pick, as much as it hurts me to say, but I think I'll take the Panthers to cover.
Okay, fair enough. I will also be taking Pittsburgh. I think this is I said this a dozen times last week, and by the way, it worked out pretty well for me. So I think I'm going to roll on this track for a while. Mm-hmm. I believe this is a 50-50 football game.
Yep.
I think this is a coin toss of who wins. So if you're going to give me 6.5 points to pick Pittsburgh, you goddamn right I'm going to take 6.5 points to pick Pittsburgh.
It's kind of my thought, too. I think it's 50-50, and you're giving me that 6.5. I'll take that.
I'm not buying the Tennessee is back thing. I'm not buying
it. No, I'm not either. All right, let's see what Odin says. Pitt is overrated, and Vols seem hyped up to go and ready to win some games and have a good year. So the game will go in their favor, but will still be close.
Look slightly above that. Scroll up.
He has Vols beating Pittsburgh by 10.
So he is picking Tennessee. Next up,
we have, we got the battle for Iowa. Is there an actual trophy there that they compete for?
Oh, there is. The first iteration of their trophy, I don't know if it was the first iteration, but there's like a famously bad, and I think they only used it for 1 year, version of the Iowa State trophy. I don't remember what the trophy's called. I'm going to call it the corn-fed trophy because that's what it should be called. And it should be an ear of corn. And I would accept nothing else.
Iowa, is that right? No way. It's called the Cy-Hawk Trophy.
That is right. It is called the Cy-Hawk. Apologies, that's a superior name. That's a cool sounding name. We have to acknowledge that the Cy-Hawk is a good name.
But Jared, look what it says above that.
Brought to you by Iowa Corn, of course. Of course it is. It is like Psyduck. You're right. Why do I know Psyduck? I don't know Pokemon, Kyle. Why did I know that?
I don't know. I'm starting to question you right now. All right.
How did I know that?
All right. The Hawkeyes are a 3.5 point favorite. Now, Jared.
Yeah.
Is Iowa going to score a touchdown in this game?
That's the question.
I didn't say 7 points. I said a touchdown.
Hey, an Iowa touchdown is still a touchdown. I don't know, Kyle. I do know that once again, I feel as though this game is very 50-50. Maybe with a slight edge. I would have said last week this game was 50-50. I would have said that last week. After Iowa's garbage performance, and let's make it clear, failing to score a touchdown against an FCS team is a garbage performance. Two safeties defense, and a field goal, touchdown Iowa style. Yeah. Maybe a little leaning Iowa State here. Maybe it's not a true 50-50 game. Maybe we're slightly leaning Iowa State here. And Iowa State is the underdog.
Yeah. I'll take the Cyclones in this one, Jared.
Yeah, we're taking the Cyclones on this one.
All right.
Hold on. Zach says, Iowa might get boat raced.
Maybe.
Iowa boat raced, not regular boat raced, Iowa boat raced, which is about 14 points. it's like they don't have water in Iowa. You know this, right? Not above ground. There's no water.
There's, right, let's see what Odin,
there's said. No elevation changes. There's no water.
All right. Odin says here, Iowa and Iowa State will be fun. But I think Iowa will actually have an offense this game after making the adjustments. Yes, Iowa winning by 7. What?
Now, is that 7 Iowa style? Is that an Iowa style 7?
So is he saying it's going to be 7-0?
It's an Iowa 7. Iowa
style 7. Yes, of course. So far, Jared and I are picking the...
But by the way, the thing I object most to in Odin's write up there is that he said it's going to be fun. It is not.
All right, so far, Jared, we are picking. We've picked every team so far here. Let's see if we'll continue that trend here with Kentucky and Florida. I think before last weekend, Kentucky would have been favored, but after seeing what Florida's victory over Utah did here last weekend, they have Florida as a 4.5-point favorite at home to Kentucky. It's a 7 p.m. kickoff on ESPN.
Yeah, I think I give a slight edge to Florida to win this game. It's a very slight edge to Florida to win this game. So, you know, if this had been 2.5, I may have gone Florida. At 4.5, Anthony Richardson looked pretty good last week, Gangland says. Yeah, he did. I just don't know how I feel about a run first quarterback in the year 2022.
Mm-hmm.
I think that college football is becoming closer to professional football, and I don't know if a run first quarterback gets it done anymore. But my problem here is that I'm also not like buying into this Kentucky hype either. I don't think they're a legit top 25 football team. So I don't really, and I'm not sold yet on Florida, for reasons. So I'm gonna, when in doubt, pick the underdog. Give me Kentucky.
All right. Well, like Tennessee, Kentucky played a MAC school too, and beat the Red Hawks 37-13. I don't remember, but yeah, it was a close game. It was 13-10 at halftime, but Kentucky obviously had the better players and outdid everything from the Red Hawks in the second half here.
Eventually the depth chart takes over.
Mm-hmm. I think Anthony Richardson is that game player. I'm just still not buying the hype. The passing was, if he can really develop the passing game, yeah, he'll be a big threat in the SEC, but until he can really pass well and do it consistently, he's just a running quarterback.
But is Kentucky good enough to expose him?
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good question, but I'll take Florida with the 4.5. Heck, I'll even take Florida at a 6.5. So I'll take Florida here.
I wouldn't take Florida at 6.5 personally, but.
All right. What does Odin say? Odin says here, Florida has a fun quarterback and he will be the reason they beat Kentucky. Yes, Florida by 7.
Yeah.
All right. Our next game, Jared, we have our primetime game. I guess it is.
Yeah, it's our, I mean, Kentucky and Florida is also primetime. I don't know if you've noticed this, Kyle. I try to stagger out the games. There's two games at noon, two games at midday. Iowa State and Iowa technically is 4 instead of 3. And then close two enough. Evening games. And then a bonus after dark game. But we'll get there later.
All right. USC and Stanford. Do you know who Stanford played, Jared, last weekend?
Ooh. It was a real stinker. I don't remember.
They played a toothpaste.
Colgate.
They did. They played Colgate. And I mean, USC didn't play anybody much better, but it is a team everybody knows, Rice, but still.
Rice is, yeah.
All right. USC is a 9.5-point favorite on the road to Stanford.
Not enough.
I got USC in a boat race here. In a boat race. Give me the Trojans.
100%.
All right. And Odin here says, I think the spread for the Stanford game is the easiest to pick out of this list. So USC by at least 14 for me.
So we're, Kyle, are you and I still completely in law? No, that's right. Florida, we split on Kentucky, Florida.
Yep. All right. And our last game, this is our, not Pac-12 after dark, but it is our late game here. Baylor and BYU.
Teams will both be Big 12 next year.
Yeah. BYU playing at home is a 3.5 point favorite.
Here's my problem. I think there's a lot of hype behind both of these teams right now. BYU is sort of, you know, as an independent, they're considered one of the better non-power five teams in the country right now. Mm-hmm. Baylor is currently ranked 9th. And I do not co-sign Baylor as a top 10 football team at all. So I think both of these teams are overrated. A lot of this is just proving my theory that there's a steep drop off after number three, whoever number three might be, there's a steep drop off. So I don't know who all deserves to be a top 10. I don't think there are 10 teams that deserve to be a top 10. So yes, that includes Baylor. But between two evils, which evils might be strong, between two overrateds, I'm going to go Baylor here. Once again, because they're the underdog, and when in doubt.
Yeah, I agree. I don't really have a strong sense either way, Jared. So 3.5 points is, I think that's enough for me to pick Baylor here. So I'll pick Baylor as well.
Yep. All right. Once again, Kyle said it at the beginning of the show. Mm-hmm. I'll point it out right here. Our seventh game is in fact Ohio State and Arkansas State. Well, we did an entire episode on that.
We can't forget about Odin though. Odin's pick.
Oh, my bad.
So he has here BYU has a decent team, and I think Baylor is crazy overrated, but it'll be a nice.
I'm not ignoring you.
Be a nice close game the whole time. He has BYU by 2. So that would be, a Baylor cover.
I'm just not going to acknowledge your soaking joke. That's all, Gangland. I'm just not going to do that. I'm not going to say that on the podcast. Why would I say that on the podcast?
All right, that is, Jared, that is all of our sloop picks.
But here. I just did.
Any other interesting games that you think might be worth watching?
Yeah, I think there are some good games on the schedule this week. Duke Northwestern is always fun because you really never know when a math equation might break out. I'm interested to see Penn State and Ohio. Ohio seemed pretty decent. Penn State did not. Kind of want to see what Penn State can do against the team that they should defeat easily. Penn State is favored by 24.5. Just to let you guys behind the scenes here. Kyle and I pick we try and space the games out, but for the most part, we try and pick games that are fun to talk about. We aren't actually trying to pick, the 7 best bets of the week. That's not what we do here. We use the whole point spread thing just to give the show some structure, right?
Yep.
And I also always tell you not to real life bet. But kind of like Ohio minus 24.5 against Penn State.
Ooh.
No, I don't think the Bobcats are going to, I don't think the Bobcats are going to pull an upset here. I'm feeling real low on Penn State after week one. But again, don't real life gamble, and definitely don't do it just because I said it. Definitely don't do it because I said it. I don't want that sort of responsibility. Illinois has a decent out of conference game going against Virginia. Both of those teams feel appropriately disappointing, just as programs in general. So that should be an even matchup. Michigan's playing Hawaii. Michigan is favored by 51 points there. I would never advise you to actually bet a game minus 51. Like, just don't ever do that. But Miami lost what feels like everyone to the transfer portal last year. Like, there's just some...
There's a lot of things just bad happening.
Just Google it. We're not going there right now.
I mean, they lost to Vanderbilt 63-10. Vanderbilt.
It's still like, I understand that it's the worst SEC team, but it's still an SEC team, right?
I don't care, Jared. I don't care. It's Vanderbilt.
Point is that I don't even know how many scholarship players Hawaii has right now. I'd be shocked if it were 85. So like, don't let your Ohio Stateness, don't be a fan here and be like, oh, Michigan, there's no way Michigan covers 51 points. They might. Like, just don't touch that one. Just don't touch that one at all. So that's your little Big Ten roundup. That was just me going through some of the Wisconsin's playing Washington State. Washington State is kind of bad. So Wisconsin's minus 17 there. If I had more faith in Wisconsin's offense, I might be like, hey. Maybe, because I think Wisconsin's better than that, but their offense just feels wibbly wobbly right now. So I wouldn't put the mortgage on that one right now.
Yep.
That was our Big Ten roundup. I didn't mention all the Big Ten teams, but that's because there's some FCS action this week. Graham Mertz equals Big Ten Bo Nix. Ooh. Whoa. Listen, am I also disappointed in Graham Mertz so far? Yes. Do I think he made a poor choice by going to Wisconsin? Yes, I do. But let's not be throwing Bo Nix around. That's cruel and unusual. You're breaking the Bill of Rights there. Don't be doing that. If anyone is Bo Nix in the Big Ten, it's Sean Clifford. Prove me wrong. Change my mind. I dare you. No, I'm it's Jared. Mertz. You're high. You're high.
I think that's it, Jared. I think that's all we have for today's episode.
Kyle, can the state of North Carolina redeem themselves this week?
Let's see. North Carolina plays Georgia State.
Not Georgia Southern, mind you. Georgia Southern's that good directional Florida. Not Georgia Tech, in case you're wondering.
Yeah. I don't think North Carolina State's playing this weekend, so they can't redeem themselves.
North Carolina State's not playing, you said?
I do not believe. I do not see North Carolina. They are. They play Charleston Southern.
That's interesting.
I saw that East Carolina is playing Old Dominion.
Who is an FBS team, in case you were wondering?
And I also see Appy State is playing Texas A&M.
That one's at least somewhat interesting. I actually legitimately almost put that in the picks, but I already had 2 3:30 games.
I wonder what the over under is on that one. 18.5.
Well, the over under is 52.5. Texas A&M's favored by 18.5. By the way, there is some conversation taking place in the Discord chat down there, and I don't know if this is the actual conversation taking place, but I'm interpreting it as, hey, who's the worst Penn State quarterback? McSorley, you have McSorley, Hackenberg, and Clifford as the three most recent quarterbacks at Penn State. Holy shit. How did Teton get a larger point spread than us? Did you hear the part where I said that Hawaii is completely decimated by the transfer portal because they had some shit go down in the program last year?
Just Google search it.
Google search Hawaii football. I don't feel like risking getting things wrong and talking about it unprepared and getting details wrong. Not gonna go there. SunCard would like us to remind you to use DuckDuckGo instead of Google. That's only if you're very concerned about your security and don't care if your results are shit.
I see here, Jared, they lost 19 players to the transfer portal.
Yeah.
I'm gonna guess they didn't bring 19 in.
All right, that's it. That is our Sloop Picks Week 2 episode.
By the way, Buckeye Zach says use Brave as your web browser. That I will co-sign.
Yes, I use Brave as well.
As do I. Yeah, that's it. That's the end of today's show. Visit thesloopcast.com. Yeah, SunCard, you always show up at the end. I don't know if you know this, but we actually have a schedule in the Discord. So thesloopcast.com, you can find links to all of the things, including our Apple Podcast page, our Spotify page, our YouTube page, our TikTok page, our Twitter pages, our Instagram page, both of our t-shirt stores, our Discord server as the icon rolls over on the frame. Come join these hooligans, these shenanigizers down here in the Discord chat. Also, in order to listen to us live, you can join the Discord for free. The Discord server is free. Anyone can join it unless you're a Michigan fan, in which case we will ban your ass.
All right.
There are also other ways that might get your ass banned. there are other methods. But if you want to listen to the show live as we record it, then you do have to be a Patreon contributor. You can be a Patreon contributor for as little as $3 a month. You can give us more if you want to give us more. There are some added benefits to paying more, but to get like all of the access to the Discord server, that will only cost you $3 a month. And it can be even cheaper than that if you pay for the 12 months up front. I believe it gives you something like an $11 or $12% discount over paying monthly. So it ends up being like $32.50 or something in that area. I forget. It's like, I don't know. It's like in the under $35 range, I believe. I don't know. I don't pay to my own Patreon. I don't know how much it costs. Let's see. SunCard says, pay the freaking $3. It is worth it. That I'm putting that on the book sleeve. There's no book, so there's no book sleeve. But if there were, I'd put that on the book sleeve. As cheap as a chain store pizza. That's Tom Orr's thing. We're significantly cheaper than a chain store pizza. We're a bad cup of coffee cheap. Tom Orr's thing doesn't work here. We're way cheaper than Buckeye Huddle. And by the way, rightfully so. Kyle and I are a pair of buffoons and they're a bunch of professionals over there. So don't think I'm comparing apples to apples there, because you know I'm not. Become a damn patron, SunCard says. These guys, or else Stuart, will show you what hogging is. He's already doing that. Zach says, pay $3 and Jared will add you on his OnlyFans. I do not have an OnlyFans that you know of. There's pigs. Oh, there's no, I don't want that. Okay. No, he's just riding it, guys. He's just riding it. We're okay. Whoo, I thought that was going somewhere else for a second. Kyle and Jared are McCafes. There you go. By the way, the McCafe coffee, not bad. I don't like McDonald's. I think generally they're terrible. SunCard says my OnlyFans is feet only. Once again, SunCard, I do not have an OnlyFans that you know of. That's untrue, Jared. You twerk on. No, I do not do that. Kyle, for God's sakes, let's end the show. They're
please, Jared.
They're please, killing Jared. Me down here. I'm trying to be good. I'm trying to be a good host and interact with our paying, contributing financial backers. But God, they're just being crazy right now. But wait, there's more. McDonald's now uses Tim Hortons coffee supplier. Yeah, absolutely. Tim Hortons, shit coffee. McDonald's, good coffee.
Speaking of restaurants here, Applebee's.
Is this Kyle's Corner?
Yes, I'm moving into Kyle's Corner here. Applebee's.
Good call.
Donovan Jackson, Luke Whippler, and Matt Jones, and Dwan Jones. I've partnered with Applebee's for an endorsement deal.
Okay.
How about that?
For the time, until that contract runs out, pretend like I've never said anything bad about Applebee's.
All right. And I think Trevion Henderson got the better end of the deal because he has an ideal with Chipotle.
Oh, that's much better.
All right.
That's much, much better.
All right. That's it. That is all we have for today's episode. No more rambling, Jared. Let's kick us out.
Tonight's ending music is by a pop punk band from the Cincinnati area. They call themselves Settle Your Scores. We've played them all week. We'll continue to play them. Lord, I was born a rambling man. I feel like there's a lot of songs from that era that include the word rambling. And I don't know what it means because they aren't talking about talking. And I don't know what that word means. And it confuses me. But we're not talking about those songs. We're talking about Settle Your Scores, who is a... I'm really glad that's not animating. I'm really glad my mouse pointer is down there and that's not animating. Settle Your Scores. Listen to them. They're good. If you're new here, the YouTube people, you can click the link down in the show notes, listen to the song. The podcast audio-only people, you can just stay right here. In fact, the song might already be playing underneath my voice. So with all that being said, I'd like to encourage everyone to drink local beer, listen to local music, and of course, support your local podcasters. Once again, this is Settle Your Scores.